For this video, the required equipment are 5 colored objects. We're using pennies. You can use t-shirts, paper, anything you have around the house. 1 soccer ball or ball that can be substituted for a soccer ball per each participant. 20 balls of any size. You can also use rolled up socks. 2 empty water bottles or anything that can be easily and safely knocked down. And 1 sofa or any area where it's safe to throw our objects, our balls of any size, into for one of our games. Have fun.
Hi, Fast Families. Coach Mike and Coach Will here, and we are here with our first Fast virtual class. Today's class is for 2-, 3-, and 4-year-old athletes. We're gonna have a lot of fun, and we can't wait for you to participate in all the great activities that we have planned for today.
Now, you're gonna need a few pieces of equipment. All of these things should be things that you can find lying around. So today we're gonna use a soccer ball per person. We're gonna use a water bottle. We're gonna need 5 different colored pieces of equipment. So potentially a t-shirt or different colored plates. And then we want 20 small balls that can be used for kicking. Coach Mike's gonna give an example here of where we can also roll socks. So you should have, hopefully you'll have at least 20 pairs of socks. But if you don't have 20 balls, you can roll the socks into little balls. Hope you have fun at the class. Okay, for our warm-up, we're gonna do our 3 warm-up moves, okay? So we've got our first move, which most of you know, we've got our breakdown, okay? We want our shoulders over our knees over our toes, and we're getting ready to catch a ball in our breakdown position, okay? And when coach says breakdown, we go, okay, we wanna be ready to catch the ball, we wanna be as loud as possible, okay? We wanna throw the roof off our house. Ready? Breakdown, breakdown, breakdown. Okay, I want to do that all together, okay? Mummies and daddies too, okay? Our second warm-up move is going to be our touch the sky, okay? So we want to bend those knees. We want to bend those knees. We want to use those arms, and we're going to touch the sky, okay? We're going to try and grab all of the lollipops from the sky or whatever your favorite snack is, okay? So we're going to bend those knees and touch the sky. Ready? Touch the sky. Touch the sky. Bend those knees. That's it. That's it. Okay, everybody? And our third move is gonna be our silly feet, okay? So, when coach says silly feet, we're gonna move those feet as quickly as possible, as quickly as possible. And then when coach says freeze, we wanna do our best statue impression, okay? So, ready? Silly feet, and silly feet, silly feet, silly feet, silly feet, silly feet, and freeze. And silly feet, silly feet, silly feet, silly feet, silly feet, and freeze. And silly feet, silly feet, silly feet, silly feet, and freeze. Good job, everybody. On to our first activity.
For our warm-up activity, musical colors, you're gonna need 5 different colored objects. We're using pennies. You can use shirts, paper, or stickers, whatever you have. You're gonna need a green, a red, an orange, a yellow, and a blue.
So for our first activity, we are gonna continue warming up with our athletic movements, okay? We have our color circle. And what we're gonna do our athletic movements around our color circle. And when the music stops, coach will tell us to find a color, and we're gonna try and find that color as quickly as possible. So, our first athletic movement is gonna be running as fast as we possibly can, but we wanna be nice and careful, okay, in whatever room we are in our house, but we're gonna try and run as fast as we can around the circle, and when the music stops, we're gonna find a color that coach says. Ready? Off we go, we're gonna do it with Coach Mike. We're gonna go along with Coach Mike, and we're gonna run as fast as we possibly can. We're gonna run as fast as we possibly can. Get those legs moving, get those arms moving. We're gonna run as fast as we can, and we're getting ready. We're getting ready, the music has stopped, and we're gonna find the yellow. We're gonna find our yellow spot. Okay, everybody, good job. Our second athletic movement, we're gonna do our big jumps. So we're gonna be like kangaroos. We're gonna bend those knees, we're gonna use those arms, and we're gonna jump all around our circle. Okay, ready? Off we go, off we go. We're doing big jumps. Big jumps all around the circle. Big jumps, you do your best kangaroo impression. Your best kangaroo impression. Bend, really bend those knees and throw those arms up. Ready? Okay, music stop, find the blue, find the blue, find the blue, find the blue. Okay, there we go. Our third athletic movement. Our third athletic movement is gonna be our bear crawl. Okay, our bear crawl. We don't want our knees to touch the ground. We're gonna crawl like a big scary bear, okay? And we're gonna move around our color circle. Ready? Off we go. Sometimes my life is like an ocean. Remember, we don't want those knees to touch the ground. We want to stay stable on our hands and feet. Following Coach Mike all around the circle. That's it, boys and girls. Okay, we're going to find the green. We're going to find the green spot. Okay, excellent job. That was a nice little warm-up for us. We're going to move on to our next activity. Okay, for our soccer toe-tap skill development, we're going to need a soccer ball and two pieces of equipment to move between. We're using two cones. You can use two water bottles, two toilet rolls, or any two markers just to go between.
For our first skill of the day, we're going to work on our little soccer toe touches. We're going to practice dribbling back and forth in between our set of cones or whatever objects you have around the house, back and forth five times, and stopping the ball with the bottom of our foot at each object. So when the music starts, Coach Will is going to show us how we're going to do little toe touches, dribbling our soccer ball back and forth between the cones to stop the ball at the cones five times. When the music starts, we're going to go. Ready? Get set, go. So he's gonna do little toe touches with his feet. Once he gets to the cone, he's gonna stop the ball at the bottom of his foot. He's gonna go back and forth in between the cones. He's at two, he's doing it three more times. There, he's got three, he's gonna go back, touch again, one more time, he's gonna get there, and freeze. All right, now, if you wanna do this a couple more times, pause the video. If you would like to play our game, keep on watching. For our washing machine challenge, we're gonna need 20 balls or socks. You know, you might be able to empty out that sock drawer and roll them all up into balls to use. We've got a spot for the kids to stop at before they throw it. And then we've got our sofa to use as our washing machine.
Okay, for our next activity, we're going to do our soccer washing machine, okay? So, Coach Will and Coach Mike, we have lots of laundry to do. Now that we're off school, we've got plenty of time, so we're going to do our laundry. So, we've got all of our laundry or our balls. Again, we can use our rolled-up socks or any small balls or big balls that we've got lying around the house. And what we're going to do, we're going to do our toe taps. So, we're going to collect one ball at a time. We're going to do our toe taps all the way to the line that we've created, and then we're going to do our two-hand overhand throw-in, okay, our soccer throw-in, and throw our ball into our washing machine. We're using our fast sofa, so you can use your sofas in your houses, okay? And we're going to try and get all of the laundry into our washing machine. We're going to do five at a time, and then we're going to see how we've done, okay? So off we go. Ready? Three, two, one, off we go. Okay, so we're doing those small toe taps. We don't want balls to go everywhere. We want to do those small toe taps. When we get to the line, we're doing our throw-in. Two hands behind our head. Going, doing our throw-in. Make sure we're doing this along with Coach Mike, everybody. So we've done our first five pieces of laundry. What's really important here is that we're keeping up those small toe taps. We don't want to see our laundry or our balls going too far ahead of us because we don't want to get tackled by the defender, okay? So we're going to do small toe taps to keep the ball under control. We've done this small space here just so that we can kind of be consistent with everybody's houses. We're not sure how big everyone's house is. We can spread our laundry out if we've got a bit more room. We don't have to be this close, okay? So we're gonna do our next five. Make sure we're doing those small toe taps and the ball isn't moving too far away from our body. Ready? Three, two, one. Off we go. Make sure that ball stays close to our feet. We wanna keep that ball close to our feet. So, hope everyone's doing that along with Coach Mike. For our next five, we're going to really concentrate on stopping the ball with the bottom of our foot when we get to the line, okay? So that's going to be our next five, and then you guys can carry on. Ready? 3, 2, 1, off we go. Make sure we're stopping the ball with the bottom with the top of our foot. So we're taking those small toe taps up the line, and then we're putting our foot on the ball. We're still doing our big, nice big throw-ins onto the sofa. Don't worry about if the ball's fall off the sofa. We're okay, we need to make sure we're doing those big throw-ins. Okay, last one. Okay, everybody, so we've got around 20 balls here. Again, you can use as many as you've got around the house. Roll up those socks into balls. Use anything that we can create so that our little ones can do our toe taps. Please continue. If you want to try that again, then pause and try again. If not, then we're looking forward to seeing you in the next activity.
Skill, you're going to need a ball or anything you can use to catch and throw, and two spots to place on the ground. We're using pennies, you can use t-shirts or pieces of paper. In this skill of the day, for our baseball catching, what we're going to practice is we're going to practice our breakdown position, keeping our hands nice and close together so that we can catch the ball and then hug it into our body. For our little ones, we want to toss underhand so it's nice and easy for them to catch, and we want to have them toss back to us underhand so it's nice and easy for them to throw. So if you're going to watch right here, Coach Will's going to get into breakdown position, his hands are close together, and then I'm going to take my ball underhand nice and easy, aim right for his hand so he can catch the ball. Now, when our little one is tossing, we want to tell him to go underhand back to us. They're going to release the ball once it passes their hip. That's what we tell them. They come back. They release it once it passes their hip, and they're going to do a great underhand throw to us. One more time, catch, just like that. If you want to practice a little bit with your little one, we encourage you to stop the video and do 5 to 10 catches with your little athlete, and then go on to our next activity of the video.
Okay, for our underhand distance throwing challenge, we're going to need 5 markers. Spaced out evenly for our distances. We're going to use 2 pieces of equipment that can be knocked down. So we're using water bottles, but anything that you happen to be knocked down, and we're going to use 1 ball.
For our underhand distance throwing challenge, what we're trying to do is we're trying to knock down our objects from different distances in our play area. Now we want to make sure we're using a ball that's safe to use in the house. We don't want to throw too hard and knock over anything we're not supposed to, all right? But what we're going to do is when the music starts, we're going to throw that ball underhand. We're going to release it once the ball passes our body to try and knock down the pins. And then every time we knock the pins down, we're going to back up 1 space. When the music starts, we're going to go. All right, Coach Will's going to knock down those water bottles. Reset them every time and back up to the next spot. If we miss, that's totally okay. We keep trying, we keep going to do it from every single spot in our play area. He's only got a couple more to go, so he's gonna roll, try and knock down those water bottles. Totally fine if we're missing. That's okay, we're gonna keep going, we're gonna keep trying, we're gonna keep practicing. We're gonna do the best we can to roll those balls and knock down the water bottles. He's only got a couple more, all right? He's got 1 more spot before he's done. He's gonna keep going. Last one, he's gonna roll, see if he gets it. Ooh, so close, he's gonna go again. So, it came on the back. Great job, look at that. All right, so, what we want you to do is we want you to try that a couple times. See how far back you can go. Maybe you can get all the way across whatever room you're using. All right? This was our last activity in our fast virtual class. Thank you very much for joining us. Hope to see you in a future one. Don't forget, it's fun to be fast.